Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel ServerGyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh and today we are going to discuss about difference of cloud computing. It means today we have majorly three platforms which are really giant in the market. So first of all is AWS, it means Amazon Web Services, then Azure Microsoft, and third one is Google Cloud Platform. So many people have been thinking like what cloud computing platform do we need to use, and if they have to suggest within their organization, so what all parameters do they need to keep in mind before suggesting it, like we can go with this and we can go with that platform. So today we are going to have a comparison between all the three. The very first one is your Amazon Web Services, second one is Microsoft Azure, and third one is Google Cloud Platform. So as of now, it is 25th of December 2018. So I'm going to compare all these three. The very first thing is like how old these are. So if you talk about Amazon, so it's been somewhere 12 years, it's in market. Then if you talk about Azure, so it's been somewhere 7 years. If you think of Google Cloud, so it's the newest one and it's been somewhere 6 years old as of now. Okay, then which one do you need to use and why? So the very first one is if we talk about AWS, so this particular section says about AWS, middle one says about your Azure, and the last one says about your this one GCP, it means Google Cloud Platform. So the very first thing is AWS is really dominant in many features like monitoring, configuration, security, and obviously if you talk about like it is feature rich, then after it has been providing those features which still do not have, still are not available on the platform of Microsoft Azure or maybe on Google Cloud. So it is feature rich, it is open and quite flexible. If you want to get anything customized on the platform of AWS, so obviously they can, maybe if you want to go for higher number of instances, do you want to get number of instances more than the default limit, so these are quite flexible. You just need to raise a ticket, you just need to raise a help ticket and they will do it for you. Global reach is available there. It means wherever you want. As of today, AWS has somewhere 16 regions available worldwide. You can create data centers anywhere around the world, wherever you want. Maybe in India and US, Canada, wherever you want, you can create a data centers. Then after, if you talk about Azure, so the integration with Microsoft tools is really broad and this is feature rich. Broad feature set, if you talk about Microsoft specific software, so these are really available over there and in vast manner. First rank for developers tool, it means the tools which are usually used for developers, you can easily find on the platform of Azure. Then after, open source support is available, so many tools which you need to use. So open source tools are integrated on the platform of Azure. Then it is hybrid cloud. It means if you have a couple of servers which are running in your on-premises data center and couple of servers you want to run in Azure cloud, so obviously this particular sort of support is available on the platform of your Azure Microsoft. Okay, then if we talk about Google Cloud, so obviously open source support and portability. For example, if you want to import any VM from your on-premises data center, so the very easiest way Google Cloud is providing. If you want to migrate your entire data center, so you can easily migrate that. Then after, discounts and flexible contracts. Obviously, you are going to get like multiple discounts. For example, if you create your new account on the platform of GCP, so you are going to get somewhere 22,000 Indian rupees, which you can use for different services and different components of Google Cloud. Then after, designed for cloud-based businesses. So if you go and if you try to explore the services of GCP, you will feel that the services which are designed on the platform of GCP, so these are cloud-based technology used. Then after, DevOps familiar, it means if you are a DevOps, so obviously you will really feel good on the platform of Google Cloud Platform. Okay, then why not to use? If someone asks you, okay, why we should not go for this particular, or why we should go for another one? So you should need to learn this particular stuff. First of all, it is difficult to use. It means so many options of AWS are there, it means unwanted options are available there. If you talk about like T2 micro and other features, so two multiple options are available there which are of almost no use, but they have enabled the features. This is feature rich, but sometimes it becomes unwanted. Like cost management is tough. If you want to customize any resource, so it is really hard and it is really tough to manage. You will have to work on this for a really long time, and you will need to understand each component, like how you can reduce your cost. So obviously, I'll not recommend that if you want to manage cost. So it is really hard on the platform of AWS. Then after, let's talk about Microsoft Azure. So it is difficult to use. Once again, unwanted options are available there. And if you talk about here, so cost management is really easy. Cost management is not that tough here, that is manageable, but is still difficult to use, and some unwanted options are available. Not all features available. Not all features. All the features which AWS is providing, so these features are not available on the platform of platform Azure. So, like you can say that it is not that supported, like all the features which you want to have. But this is only recommended only in that condition if you want to use all the softwares, all the components of Microsoft, then you should go with this. Okay, now let's talk about Google Cloud. As it is like newcomer, or you can call it like late entry in IaaS market, so data centers are less, number of features and services are less. So you will have to think like what sort of component you are going to use on the platform of Google Cloud. Only after that you are supposed to use it. Then after, if you talk about market share, so as of today, AWS has somewhere 51% of overall market share. Azure has somewhere 20%, and Google Cloud has somewhere 12% of market share. Okay. Then if you talk about growth rate, so Jeffrey is the particular site where I studied it, and I thought of sharing the particular stuff. So 42% annual growth AWS has as of today, 89% growth your Microsoft Azure has. Then after 125, the biggest player in the market as of today, if you really want to learn some cloud computing platform, so I will suggest you for Google Cloud, because obviously more and more companies are hiring for those candidates who are looking, who are working, or who are like knowledge rich with the Google Cloud platform. Okay, finally, pricing. So if you talk about pricing, so AWS charges for its component on hourly basis, Microsoft Azure charges on minute basis, and in the same fashion, if you talk about your Google Cloud platform, so it is also charging for the resources on a minute basis. It means this is cost optimized. If you want to run your server maybe for 5 minutes, so you will be charged only for 5 minutes, not for entire hour. This is the drawback of AWS. So I hope this makes sense. And obviously, if you want to go for if you want to suggest any particular cloud computing platform, so you can use this particular stuff here. So this will be really helpful for you. Like you can talk about AWS, Azure, Google Cloud platform, why to use, why not to use, what is market share, and obviously what is growth of all this. Then after pricing and rest of the stuff I have already discussed with you. So I hope this is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good time. Happy learning from ServerGyan. If you have any further questions, so please do write in comment box. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Share it with your friends. And if you have any questions, so do write in comment box. I shall be happy to help. Happy learning. Thank you very much.